Welcome back to the channel. Today, we're diving deep into a crucial and highly specialized topic, how to properly apply casts for different types of foot fractures, specifically the suropodalico, huarache, and Swedish shoe casts. These casting techniques are essential for ensuring proper healing and providing the right support during recovery. Whether you're a healthcare professional looking to refine your skills or just curious about how these unique casts are applied, you're in the right place. Stick around because we're about to break down each step, explain why each method is used, and share some expert tips to make sure the cast fits perfectly every time. Understanding the foot fracture and choosing the right cast. Before we get into the actual casting process, it's important to understand why different foot fractures require different types of casts. The foot is a complex structure with 26 bones, and each fracture can impact your mobility and recovery in different ways. Choosing the correct type of cast, whether it's the suropodalico, huarache, or Swedish shoe cast, depends on the location and severity of the fracture, as well as the patient's activity level and overall health. 1. Suropodalico cast. Often used for fractures of the metatarsals or midfoot, providing excellent support while allowing limited movement of the toes. 2. Huarache cast, a flexible option that supports the arch and heel, ideal for fractures that need a bit more stability but still allow for some foot movement. 3. Swedish shoe cast, designed for more severe fractures. This cast immobilizes the entire foot and lower leg, offering maximum protection and stability. Applying the suropodalico cast. 2, 3. Let's start with the suropodalico cast, a favorite for metatarsal fractures. Here's how you apply it. 1. Preparation. Start by positioning the patient's foot at a 90-degree angle to the leg, ensuring the foot is relaxed. This is crucial for ensuring the cast sets in the correct position. 2. Padding. Apply a layer of soft padding to protect the skin and bony prominences, especially around the ankle and the metatarsal heads. This padding will also help with comfort and prevent sores. 3. Casting material. Using fiberglass or plaster, begin wrapping the material from the toes up to the mid-calf. The key is to ensure even coverage and avoid any tight spots that could restrict circulation. 4. Molding. As the material begins to set, gently mold it to the contours of the foot, ensuring it provides support without being too tight. Pay special attention to the arch and metatarsals. Applying the huarache cast. 3. Next up is the huarache cast, which is perfect for fractures that need a bit more arch and heel support. Here's the step-by-step process. 1. Foot positioning. Like with the suropodalico cast, start with the foot at a 90-degree angle. This positioning ensures that the cast supports the foot correctly during healing. 2. Padding and splints. Apply padding, but also incorporate splints along the sides of the foot to enhance stability. These splints help maintain the shape of the arch and provide additional support. 3. Casting material. Begin wrapping from the toes, ensuring the material is snug but not too tight. The material should extend to just below the knee, providing ample support for the heel and arch. 4. Final adjustments. Once the material begins to harden, focus on shaping the arch and heel areas. The goal is to create a cast that supports the foot's natural shape, reducing the risk of complications during healing. Applying the Swedish shoe cast, 410-530. The Swedish shoe cast is the most robust of the three, often used for severe fractures that require full immobilization. Here's how you apply it. 1. Initial positioning. Position the foot at a slightly relaxed angle, rather than the strict 90 degrees used in the other casts. This slight relaxation helps accommodate swelling and ensures comfort. 2. Padding. Because this cast is more restrictive, generous padding is crucial. Pay extra attention to the heel, ankle, and lower leg to prevent pressure sores. 3. Casting material. Begin wrapping from the toes, ensuring complete coverage of the foot, ankle, and lower leg. The Swedish shoe cast often extends to just below the knee, offering maximum protection. 4. Reinforcement. As the material hardens, consider adding an extra layer around the heel and ankle for added stability. This reinforcement is essential for preventing movement and ensuring the foot remains fully immobilized. 5. Final shaping. Once the material has begun to set, carefully mold it to ensure it provides full support without being too tight. The final cast should be sturdy, providing a solid foundation for the foot to heal correctly. Final tips and post-casting care, 5:30 to 6:30. With the cast applied, it's important to ensure the patient understands how to care for it and what to expect during the recovery process. 1. Elevate and rest. Advise the patient to keep the foot elevated as much as possible in the first few days to reduce swelling. Rest is key during the initial stages of healing. 2. Monitor for tightness or discomfort. Instruct the patient to monitor for any signs of tightness, numbness, or increased pain, as these could indicate complications such as swelling or impaired circulation. 3. Follow-up appointments. Stress the importance of attending all follow-up appointments. These visits allow the healthcare provider to check on the healing process and adjust the cast if necessary. 4. Keep the cast dry. Remind the patient to keep the cast dry, especially during showers, to prevent weakening of the cast material and the development of skin issues. Conclusion, 6:30, 7:10. And there you have it, a detailed look at how to apply Suropodalico, Huarache, and Swedish shoe casts for foot fractures. Each method has its unique applications and benefits, and knowing when and how to use them is crucial for optimal patient outcomes. If you found this video helpful and informative, don't forget to hit that like button, share it with your colleagues or friends who might benefit from this knowledge, and subscribe to Dr. Maximo's channel for more in-depth orthopedic insights. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.